Hey, how's it? I noticed we had some deep earthquakes in the last couple of days. Going back yesterday, Sunday the 14th, we had, there's a couple earthquakes. Alaska had a 3.3 that was 116 kilometers deep, and then Japan had a 4.7 that was 107 kilometers deep. Papua New Guinea had one that was 95 kilometers deep. Alaska, Mount Redoubt again, 108 kilometers deep. And then they had another one that was 183 kilometers deep. Colombia had a 4.3 that was 176 kilometers deep. Indonesia had one that was 296 kilometers deep. And then the Fiji Islands had a 4.5 that was 502 kilometers deep. That's over 300 miles. That's deep. And then Alaska at Anchor Point, they had a small 2.6 that was 107 kilometers deep. And now Futuna, they just had this 5.1 pop up. 5.1 magnitude. There's no tsunami window up, so that's good. This earthquake was 257 miles deep. The tectonic summary says the eastern margin of the Australia plate is one of the most seismically active areas of the world due to high rates of convergence between the Australia and the Pacific plates. And the ARSO map also shows the 5.1 magnitude Futuna. And the L-Wave map looks quiet. I don't know. This chart here is in Beijing, China. And there hasn't really been any activity there. Everything else looks pretty quiet. And we have this weather system that's dropping down on Hawaii, and it's bringing rain. And we need it. On the sun, it looks like we have six numbered spots, one of which looks like it produced a CME that is not Earth-facing. And the auroral oval is activity level 4. And this bird flu in China keeps going up. Death toll now is at 14. Total cases 63. I'll leave a link to this article in the description. Everyone have a good evening. Aloha.